probably this episode, there is no significance for this episode unless there is some sort of symbolic significance, because Saptarshi, the commentators also have not written anything. Even the Sanskrit commentators, they have not written anything on that. But in the Upanishad, Saptarshi has a significance. Saptarshi, we refer to what is this, Gautama, Atri, etc., Vishwamitra, Bharadvaja and others. But Saptarshi in the Upanishads, they refer to the seven orifices which are in a human head. So, we have got two eyes and two ears and two nostrils and one mouth. So, these are the seven indriyas which are there in the head, which are the means of say knowledge. Indriya means mouth, of course, not only eat but also it tastes. That's that rasanendriya it is called. It tastes, it gives the knowledge of the taste. So, this is sense of hearing, sense of smell, sense of taste, sense of sight. So, these seven orifices which are related to indriyas. Indriya means that which acquires knowledge. So, these are called saptarshayah. Maybe some such a symbolic meaning may be there. So, which means that this is a place which is purifying in nature. This is a place where great rishis have done tapas, and this is a very, very auspicious place. And this is a place which is some sort of giving a nice pleasant experience to people here, a sort of refreshing experience. So, which they had not done earlier. So, they had not done earlier in the first bout, for the first round of fight when they went, they did not see this place. In the second round, Rama observes this place and then asks Sugriva what it is. Then Sugriva knows about it, but then in the first instance, he had totally ignored it. Now, they all go there, they all pay respects there. Abhivadya cha dharmatma ramo bhrata cha lakshmana, they all bow there. So, probably this is basically, this might have been introduced by Valmiki to show that in all such places, wherever you are traveling, you have to pay respects to some sort of holy place, some sort of say sacred place. If it is there en route, you have to pay respects. So, probably that is what they missed out earlier. So, maybe that is the hint which is being given by Valmiki. Otherwise, there is no explanation for this, because one full sarga is used to describe the forest, how they moved in that forest and what not, and how the elephants were there and all the birds were there and nice beautiful trees and some holy trees are also there. In our tradition, there are certain holy trees also. Say for example, Mandaraha Parijatascha, Mandaraha Parijatascha. So, like that there are some trees which are considered to be holy trees. So, all that description is there basically to say that they have now got a sort of refreshing, a reassuring experience after going there and then after paying respects to that place. So, then after that we come to the next sarga where this Sugriva and all these people, they again go. Sugriva again raises a battle cry. So, at that time what happens, we will see in this next 14, in this 14th sarga. Then again all these people they went. Then Vrukshaihi Atmanam Avrutya Vyatishthan Gahane Vane. They all just stood behind the trees and they just they were standing there, whereas Sugriva went ahead and he gave out a Tatastu Nenadam Ghoram Kurtva Yuddhaya Chahvayat. He again challenged Vali for a fight. Come out. He just gave a roar. And Sugriva, but having given a roar again, Sugriva again is slightly panicky. So, he is again and again pleading to Rama, you please shoot him. Tameva uvacha vachanam Sugrivam Shatrusudanaha. Then Rama again reassured him, don't worry, now you have got an abhijnanam, you have got a mark of identification round your neck, you have got this Gajapushpa mala. So, I will be able to say identify you, don't worry. So, he gives assurance again and again. So, then again he goes. And Rama again assures him, I have never made any sort of false promise, he says. Anrutam nokta purvam me. I have never told a lie. I have never made any sort of false promise which I did not fulfill. I always fulfilled my promise. So, don't worry. So, then Sugriva again feels reassured, again goes and then again raises a battle cry. He gave the end. Then again we come to the next sarga, that is 15th sarga, where Vali listens to that cry. And again, Vali becomes say very furious, right? This fellow very recently I bet him and then drove him away. This fellow again is challenging me. So, Vali again, he is in this Antapura, probably it was evening time. And again, he was in the middle of his women. And Vali gets furious. He got up very angrily. Rosha Paritanga. Rosha means very ferocious. So, Rosha and ferocious, they look similar. Anyway, he rose up in a very ferocious way, and eyes again, Deeptagni Lochanah, eyes red with blood, and red like fire rather, Deepta Agni, Agni Lochanah, eyes were red like fire, and with all that fury he came out. Then his wife Tara is there. Tara is a wise lady. We are going to see in this whole Ramayana, Tara is a very wise lady, and she knows the divine nature of Rama. Tara knows the divine nature of Rama, and Ravana's wife Mandodari also knows the divine nature of Rama. So there are certain characters in say Valmiki's Ramayana who know that there is something special about Rama. So Tara is now telling about what she has heard from say Angada. Angada is their son. Angada is the son of Vali and Tara. So now Tara, when this Vali is rushing out, Tara comes in between, and then she embraces him. Tamtu Tara Parishwajya Snehad Darshita Saukhruda. Out of love for him, she embraces him, and she says, you can go in the morning. You need not go right now. This fellow is challenging. Very recently he was defeated. Very recently, Purvam Apatitah Krodhat. So this fellow came earlier, and then he was defeated by you. He was beaten black and blue. Again he is coming and challenging you for a fight, which means in my mind there is a serious doubt about it. There must be a very, very strong reason for this. And she says, surely he has now got some help. Na sahayam aham manye. He is surely with some friend. He has not come helpless. So he has come with a friend. Na aparishita veeryena Sugriva sakhyameshyati. I have heard that Sugriva has made friends with some people. And Sugriva doesn't make friends with anybody unless he examines them, unless he tests them. Na aparishita veeryena. Aparishita veeryam is somebody whose valor has not been tested. So Sugriva doesn't make a friendship with anybody whose valor has not been tested. So obviously he has tested, and then he has made friends. And not only that, Angada has given me this news. Angada, our son Angada, while he was moving in the forest, some of the spies, even in the Vanara kingdom, they have got their own informant network, and then spies and whatnot, their own intelligence personnel. So they gave him information that there are two people, the two princes Rama and Lakshmana have come. They are said to be very, very valorous. Ayodhyadipateh Putrav, they are the children, they are the two sons of Ayodhyadipati, that is Dasharatha. And Rama is so, and about Rama's character, Tara is describing in several shlokas. Tara is describing Rama Parabalamardi Yugantagnirivothita. He is like the fire, Yuganta Agni. Fire at the time of that great, at the end of this kalpa, there is supposed to be a huge fire, Yuganta Agni. So he is like that huge conflagration at the end of a particular kalpa. And not only that, but at the same time, he is a Nivasa Vrukshaha Sadhunam. For good people, he is a Nivasa Vrukshaha. Nivasa Vruksha means he is the Ashraya, he is the shelter for all the people. He is the shelter like a great tree. A tree gives a shade to whoever comes to it. Tree doesn't go to them, but you have to go to a tree. So, which means whoever comes as an ashrita, whoever comes seeking help. So, this Rama has got a tendency to give them all help, and not only shelter, the tree gives them say fruits, flowers, etc. It gives shelter, fruits, flowers, etc. So, similarly, Rama is a person who gives all these to whoever seeks his refuge.